Hey, what it do, traders? Welcome back to my YouTube channel. So in this video, I'm going to be revealing to how I was able to make a whopping $600 and also giving you the strategy for free. As you can see, the trades have been closed. Focus, Wena. The trades have been closed and some trades are basically still running because, you know, it's never enough, right? It's never enough. So do smash on that like button for me, guys, as I'm giving you this strategy for free. And remember to not get scammed by those that claim to be me. I'm not selling anything in the Forex trading space. I'm giving out information for free. So without wasting any of your time, let us head over to our charts. Cool. And before we proceed, let us look at a video that I took when placing this trade.
So I just took a buy on AUDCHF, prices basically on my daily flip zone, right? So what I did is I never really entered when price was basically retesting my flip zone, but I waited for price to somehow form a trend within a trend. And as you can see, this is the
price. Right, so we can see that price did move to the upward as I placed those buy orders, right? And then price right now is on my previous what is on my previous higher high. I just took some partial profits, right? And then I have some orders still running because I haven't gotten enough of what I'm basically looking for, right? So before we get in deep, I want you all to look at this, right? Please note that I used the daily time frame for confirming my entries, right? I used the daily time frame for doing what? For confirming my entries. If I can just remove this, right? You can see that price was where? Price was on my flip zone, right? Price moved away from this flip zone and then it came back to do what? And then it came back to, and then it came back to retest it, right? And then we have a candlestick pattern on the daily time frame. We basically have a bullish engulfing candlestick pattern on the daily time frame. Now, you're probably asking yourself that why did I use the daily time frame to confirm my entries, right? First things first that you have to note is that I basically magnified my entries on the daily time frame. Yes, I did wait for the daily candlestick pattern to be complete, to be closed, right? And then I took the trade the next day, but I then magnified my entries, right? Meaning that if I entered when the, let me just remove this also. Right, meaning that if I basically entered when this candlestick pattern was complete, I never really put my stop loss there at the beginning of the candlestick pattern, but I put it somewhere there. Somewhere there, why? Because I had magnified my entries, right? So please note that I'm not going to get in detail, or I'm not going to get in deep with the strategy, because, you know, it's my strategy and sometimes I feel bad for giving it away. But you know, I feel like I can reveal all of the secrets only if you can give me 600 likes and at least 300 comments on this video. So I don't really think that it would be that hard. Just give me 600 likes and 300 comments and I'm going to get in detail and I'm going to get in deep with this trading strategy. But as of right now, let me just continue explaining to you about this strategy. And if you have questions, you can simply post them on the comment section, right? So I am going to reveal some things here, but I'm not going to get in deep, right? So what happened here is, right, on the daily time frame, guys, I want you all to know that as most of you guys know that as you go up high in the time frames, right, there is where the accuracy is. The higher the time frame, the more chances of you winning on that particular trade. I'm sure that most of you guys basically know that if you entered on a higher time frame, right, the higher time frames are more accurate than the smaller time frames when it comes to entries, right? So there is the first reason that I decided to use the daily time frame, or that is the first reason that I decided to use the daily candlestick pattern and then magnify my entries on the daily candlestick pattern, because the stop loss of this entry would have been somewhere around 109 pips. So I then tried to do what? I then magnified my entries, and that is what I'm going to be revealing to you, how I was able to magnify my entry, right? So I'm sure that you, most of you guys, understand that price is on my flip zone, right? So I magnified my entries using the what? Using the 15 minutes time frame, right? Excuse me, right? So let us just circle our daily candlestick pattern here. Stick with me in order for you to properly understand what I'm unpacking, right? So this is my daily candlestick pattern, right? This is my daily candlestick pattern, as you guys can see. And then I magnified this entry using the what? using the 15 minutes time frame, right? So basically, this is where the daily candlestick pattern closed. Let me just remove this. This is where the daily candlestick pattern closed, right? And then what is it that I did? I took my entry there, right? So now, when I took my entry here, right? When I took my entry there, I couldn't put my stop loss here. I had to find a zone that I knew exactly that price won't be able to reach, right? I had to find a zone somewhere here, somewhere there, that I knew exactly that price is not going to be able to do what, is not going to be able to reach, right? So what happened was, I went over to the 15 minutes time frame, and you can see that inside of the daily candlestick pattern, on the 15 minutes time frame, there was already a trend, right? Inside of the daily candlestick pattern, there was a 15 minutes time frame trend, and this is the trend that I used to help know where I'm going to place my stop loss, right? Stick with me in order for you to properly understand what I'm unpacking, right? So what happened was, I had to draw trend lines on where, on the 15 minutes time frame. And I'm going to explain why I had to draw multiple trend lines on the 15 minutes time frame, right? So I had to draw multiple trend lines on the 15 minutes time frame, right? Let me just draw these multiple trend lines, right? So you can basically see, let's continue drawing these trend lines, right? Okay, so you can basically see, let's just wait for it to load. So you can basically see that on the 15 minutes time frames, these are the what? These are the only trend lines that were there for me to draw, right? I'm going to explain to you why I had to draw these trend lines, right? So now remember that my entry is where? My entry is here, right? After the daily candlestick pattern closed, I waited for the next day and then I took my entry where? I took my entry there. Why did I draw my trend lines on the 15 minutes time frame, right? I drew them to help me know where I'm going to place my what? My stop loss. I have to place my stop loss below all of these trend lines. Why should I do that, right? I did that because I knew exactly that, oh, okay, price might reject and then come back, right? And then try to work on this trend line and then maybe break this trend line and then come to this trend line, or maybe break this trend line but there are less chances of it breaking this trend line, or maybe it breaking this trend line but there are less chances of price doing what? Of price breaking this trend line, right? Price might then reverse from this trend line, right? So basically, these trend lines were there to help me know where price might not reach. Because I knew that, okay, if price does retrace, it's going to come across these trend lines that are going to help push price to the upward. So I had to make sure that I put my stop loss way below all of these trend lines. Because putting my stop loss here, right, would have made me have a less risk to reward ratio. It would have made me have what? A huge stop loss. So I had to try as much as possible to do what? To draw this trend line so that I know where to put my stop loss. And you can see that my stop loss is where? My stop loss is just slightly below all of these trend lines. Because I know that there are few chances of price breaking all of these trend lines. Like it might break the first trend line, right? It might break the first trend line. It might break the second trend line. But, you know, the third trend line is going to give price some trouble. And also the fourth trend line might give price some trouble. And then price might react from any of these trend lines. Price might then reverse and continue doing what? And continue moving to the upward. So I want you to basically understand the full concept of why I used the daily time frame for confirming my entries. I used the daily time frame for confirming my entries because it is so accurate. The daily time frame is so accurate when it comes to entries. But the main problem that I had was that on the daily time frame, there is a huge stop loss, right? And once I have a huge stop loss, that means that I'm going to do what? I'm going to have a less risk to reward ratio. So that is why I then came up with this thing to do what? To have a tighter stop loss so that I can have a what? So that I can have a better risk to reward ratio while having a what? While having an accurate entry. Because I waited for a daily candlestick pattern to do what? To close, right? And then I'm now expecting to get a what? I'm now expecting to get a 1:3 risk to reward ratio, right? And what happened here is I already took partial profits when price hit this previous high, right? And now I've just protected my what? I've just protected my profits, and then I'm waiting for price to do what? To give me that 1:3 risk to reward ratio. But I already took some partial profits when price beat this previous high, right? So you can see that it is a bit possible for price to do what? For price to give me this 1:3 risk to reward ratio. But if I had placed my stop loss here, right, then it means that my 1:3 risk to reward ratio would be somewhere there. Right? Which is a bit impossible, right? So the reason why I then decided to go over to the 15 minutes time frame and magnify my entries was for this reason, to get a tighter stop loss, right? So I'm not going to get in deep with the strategy as of right now, guys, because, you know, I really need to see that you guys are enjoying the content. I really need to see that you guys are finding value in this in the videos that I'm basically releasing. So give me at least 600 likes on this video and at least 300 comments so that I release the full modified version of this strategy, right? So that's it for this video, guys. See you on the next one. Cool.